Good afternoon, everyone. This is Robert T. Green, the CEO of Pre-Post Game. Welcome to the Pre-Post Game podcast, sponsored by the African American Athlete, hosted by Mr. Ricky Hampton and Michael Robinson. Check them out every Tuesday at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. They cover African American Athlete from the sports perspective, from past to present, and certainly the future. We're doing this podcast to talk about basically Ed Oliver and Major Applewhite. If this video educates, empowers, protects you anyway, please like and share this video. Again, my name is Robert T. Green, the CEO of Pre-Post Game, Sports Business Management, Transition Succession Planning. For more information, you can check us out at The Players Rep 1 on Twitter, The Players Rep 1 on Instagram, The Players Rep on Facebook, but also PrePostGame.com. So now that we got those things out the way, I've been chopping at the bit all day to speak on this actual matter. So first of all, let me basically say that by no means do I or do my company or anyone associated with us condone Ed Oliver's actions on retaliating to what happened last night against Tulane versus his coach. Ed Oliver, as a young man, have to understand that he's more than an athlete. And regardless of the fact of who approaches him and what they do, whether it's a coach, whether it's a fan, whether it's someone else in the sports industry or industry in life, period, you got to learn how to basically walk away from situations. Now, with that being said, and get that out the way, again, the jacket is innocent. The jacket is innocent. The bullying and narrative of what happened last night is not. For those who don't know, the timeline goes, Ed Oliver, a projected top five pick for the NFL draft 2019, was injured on October 20th versus Navy. When Ed Oliver was injured versus Navy, over the last three games, Ed Oliver has been training, recovering to get better to play. And at this point, many say that Ed Oliver has now gotten well and is deciding not to play any further for Houston and get basically milking the opportunity to not play on the field. Now, I'm going to explain this to people really slow. The University of Houston is a school. Houston does not pay Ed Oliver, his parents, his family's bills. However, what Ed Oliver has done on and off the field for the University of Houston does pay Major Applewhite, the universities, the administration, the other coaches' bills. All that is done on the behest and the behalf of Ed Oliver. Yet Ed Oliver is the one that's taking all the risk. So, when I talk about narratives in the sports business and how kids are made to be vilified. Now, everybody knows in the beginning of the game, Ed Oliver was seen running around, catching, jumping, catching passes before the game, which many might say, well, he was able to play. And that may be so. But by no means is Ed Oliver, if he decides not to play, he is not required to put his livelihood on the line to jeopardize his family's future in order to take care of the University of Houston and Major Applewhite's family. So now that we got that out the way, secondarily speaking, a good coach, character development, teachable moment, if you will, would be best suited for Major Applewhite is if he really wanted Ed Oliver and his role to not wear that jacket. There are several ways he could express that and got that conveyed to that young man without belittling him, without trying to make a point, without trying to look at your best player and have all these other kids believe that, hey, if I can bully Ed Oliver, I can bully you too. That was the nerve that was shown by Major Applewhite last night. And it's deplorable. And once again, it goes to show you that when you talk about this whole team thing, the reality is the team only factors in when it's best beneficial for the actual person that's making money off of these actual players and these families' best interests. What Major Applewhite could have and should have done is either waited to halftime, or he could have walked over to Ed Oliver and put his arms around them, if you will, in a comforting manner. It's called knowing how to address your student athletes, address those that literally are the reason why your bread is butter. Clearly, he did not get that. NCAA coaches, DJ Durkin, Jimbo Fisher, Major Applewhite, keep your hands off of these kids. You all are employees. If anybody went to work today, and at the end of the day, you're trying to do your job, and someone decides to come up to you at your desk, well, no matter what you're wearing, and tell you you can't wear it and proceed to pull it off of you, what would your actions be? Although we know what they would be. So when you try to justify a grown man who's making millions of dollars, his actions of actually putting his hands on this young man and then vilify this young man for a response that any human being with common sense that God gave him would be worse at some times. And once again, Ed Oliver, a future multimillionaire, can't take the bait. Narratives about the college and NFL game is such as this. In college, they tell you everything you want to hear, not what you need to know, simply to get you to sign off because you really got nothing to gain. Ed Oliver would have been a top five pick if he played for Houston, LSU, Alabama, anywhere else. Just like about 15 other guys that's going to be drafted in the 2019 NFL draft class. So with that being said, you have to know your worth. And your worth is a lot more than letting allowing Major Applewhite, a guy who was not the reason why you came to Houston, neither was Tom Herman, who, again, did what's best for Tom Herman, left the team and Ed Oliver to take a job at Texas, making millions of dollars. So, with that being said, yes, Ed Oliver did cost himself some money, likely, but the reality is the most important thing is that Ed Oliver has to understand the business that he's in. Because they're your teammates, because they're your coach, don't mean they have your best interests in mind. Sports is not a game. Sports is all business. Major Applewhite, you need to understand something, and every other coach for that matter, I don't care what level it may be. The reality is, there is no coaching profession without the actual player. So if a kid comes to your university, your program, your school, and his mother and father allows you to basically help develop their character, for those who say Ed Oliver is arrogant, he's bigger than the program, I say to you, what program? Everything that University of Houston has done over the last 2 to 3 years through ESPN on TV and media has been an exploitation of Ed Oliver. Again, Ed Oliver's been Ed Oliver. He came there 16, 17-year-old. If he was immature then, and he may be immature now, at the end of the day, Major Applewhite, Tom Herman, shall be held accountable at the highest level. But once again, how can you say Major Applewhite is going to put Ed Oliver in the best situation when he is the coach and literally was sleeping with a student athlete, a student assistant, just 2 years ago in a bowl game and got a bonus for it? So again, as I always say, what they say, miss these kids and these families with that BS because it's a business. The reality is the NFL have a lot more players that do a lot of things that are scrupulous and detrimental to the team, detrimental to society, and yet they turn the other way. Let's take the Cowboys, for example. Who you want to start with? Michael Irvin, Randy Gregory, Nate Newton, Greg Hardy, all these guys on America's team that got all type of drugs and off-the-field action problems. That's Bryant, Pac-Man Jones. Stop me when you get here. Haven't won a Super Bowl since 1996, yet they call themselves America's team. Jerry Jones is the best real estate agent there is. Basically, he got the Jerry's house making money on every game, every day of the week. Yet the Cowboys fans keep buying tickets thinking that you guys trying to win Super Bowl. How? He's made a living off of hiring guys that get in trouble with the law. Most recently, Ezekiel Elliott. Trust the facts, not the process. So before you guys start being holding in thou on Ed Oliver, the kid that's trying to get to where he wants to be, understand you are who you surround yourself with. So if Ed Oliver got a problem, it ain't him that got the problem. It's the University of Houston. It's the NCAA. The fact of the matter is, I am imploring Ed Oliver and those like Ed Oliver at this point, talking about what you need to do. He needs to not play another down for the University of Houston so the NCAA and everybody else can't make another dollar red cent off his name, likeness, and image. Let's stop kidding ourselves. He went to the University of Houston because his brother was there. That's his family. That's his team. What Major Applewhite did last night didn't show anything about team, didn't show anything about character, didn't show anything about leadership, didn't show anything about anything that people like to spew and spit when it comes down to this whole business of sport. Once again, Ed Oliver is wrong in his response. The jacket is innocent. The bully tactics, Major Applewhite in Houston saying that coach kids can't wear jackets and they only got 50 of them. How many of those jackets that Ed Oliver is directly responsible for helping them get paid? And if you're not careful, Major Applewhite, why don't you pay attention to Bobby Petrino? Ask him how he's doing right now. When last year, when all the scouts and everybody tried to get Lamar Jackson to return to Louisville, and he didn't. How fast did that train come off the rails? Now word is Jeff Brohm is going to leave Purdue with Rondell Moore, one of the greatest receivers as a freshman in the history of the NCAA, to take the Louisville job. Again, team, right? So Rondell Moore is going to basically be responsible for Jeff Brom going to make millions back at his alma mater. He's supposed to sit there and like it because coach said. You know, the same coach, DJ Durkin, should players continue to do what coach said. Coach Jerry Sandusky said coaches, players can do the same thing. What about Coach Larry Nassar? What about the Ohio State wrestling team? What about this guy, Bobby Woodbury? I mean, Mike Woodbury. Because you got the title, coach, don't mean anything to these players. Like, earn the right to demand respect, to command the respect of these athletes and these families. It's like the 50s and 60s. And I implore any coach that's out here that's watching this video, if you feel like it's in your best interest to put these hands on these kids for whatever reason, please let me know. I'll be glad to help support you. Look for your next profession. Between myself, the family, the kid, and their attorneys, you're not going to like the results. I don't apologize for this. I repeat, Ed Otto was wrong responding the way he did. Ed, you have to be smarter than that. Fact of the matter is, though, NCAA, these coaches, you guys need to get off your high horse and stop acting like you're the reason why these kids are winning. You're not. Yep. They're not the reason. They are. And this is Robert T. Green, the CEO of Pre-Post Game, the players are here to educate and protect the athletes and the family's best interests alone. This video empowered you, protected you, educated you. Anyway, please like and share. Check us out again. You guys be well. God bless and have a great weekend.